Hi everyone and welcome back to the channel. In today's video of how to play Spectre Operation, we will be looking at breaching. Breaching is a tactical action and it's done in the movement and tactical action phase. When you want to attempt a breach, you will need to roll based on that breach table. There are multiple types of target you can breach through. It can be a window, an internal door, up to a concrete or thick adobe wall. And here on the right, you can be equipped with different tools. Maybe you have nothing, maybe you have a breaching weapon, a shotgun, maybe you have a breaching tool like a hammer, or maybe you have a breaching charge. So let's for example take a look at the external door. Usually if you don't have anything equipped, you're just kicking that door with your feet, you will need to roll and have a 6 plus to be able to go through that door. If you have a breaching weapon like a shotgun, it will be reduced to a 4 plus. And if you have a hammer, it will be a 2 plus. And for the breaching charge, it's completely automatic. Let's have a look at an example. In today's example, I have some Ghost Recon Special Force operator that try to enter in that small Afghan village. For the first example, here I'm going to breach through that door over here. So let's do a first example. Here, my first Ghost Recon operator, which is just a basic rifleman that doesn't have equipped any breaching weapon or breaching charge, he will move and enter base-to-base contact with that door. So it's still his movement. During the movement of that miniature, he can do the tactical action of breaching through that door. To do that, I will simply take my die and roll it. Here I roll the 3. As we saw on the table, we needed a 6 plus to be able to breach through that door. That means that in that case, that door will remain closed. On the next turn, because I already tried to open it, now I'm adding 1 point to my dice because the door took some damage, so it will be easier for each following turn to breach through that door. So on the next turn, instead of being a 6 plus, I will need to roll a 5 plus. So now let's say that I didn't took that basic rifleman, but I took that breacher. That breacher is equipped with multiple things. He's carrying that shotgun that you can see in between his legs. And on the back here, we can see he's equipped with a breaching charge. So let's try to use that shotgun first. So that model, it's still the movement phase of my wall force. So let's say that that guy moved to just be in front of the door, that guy moved just taking cover on the other side. Now it's the turn for that model to move. I'm going to move it through the door and I'm going to use my shotgun to try to breach through the door. So the shotgun, as we saw, it's an external door. Sorry for the reflection of the light. It's an external door and I need a breaching weapon. I need a 4 plus to breach through that door. So again, I'm going to take my die. I'm going to roll it. This time I rolled a 5. That means that I can breach through that door. That door is now completely open and I can keep moving my guy and enter that building. Same for the rest of my team, if I want multiple guys to enter it, I will be able to do so. If a door is locked or open will really depend on the scenario you are building. This can be defined by the scenario, this can be also completely randomized. That's what I'm usually playing with all my games. When I encounter a door, I'm going to roll a die. On a 1, 2, 3, the door will be open, and on a 4, 5, 6, the door will be closed. This adds a bit of randomness and adds just various kind of situations you will need to deal with. If you try to breach with a weapon like the shotgun we just did over here, that makes noise. Same when you try with a breaching charge, for example. So if I breach with my shotgun, the shotgun is not equipped with a silencer, that shot will be heard up to 36 inches. That means that the wall force here will be alerted by that. So instead of using a shotgun, what we could use is some lockpicks. When you are using a lockpick, you can silently open a locked door, and to do that you need to pass an agility test with a -1 modifier. So here is the card for my Ghost Recon Operator. They have an agility of 5. So usually I can only fail that agility test on a 6. But because of that minus 1 using the lockpick, which is quite an advanced tool to use, this is reduced to a 5+. So let me roll the die, and here I roll a 3. That means I can breach silently if I am equipped with that lockpick. I can breach silently and enter that building. If I roll a 5 or a 6, the door will remain closed for that turn. I could try again the following turn, but the advantage is that it doesn't make any noise. Also, who is equipped with lockpick should be defined in the at the start of the game. You can't just say, hey, everyone is equipped with a lockpick, or maybe he is, but this really need to be defined between the players before the mission start. Same for any breaching charge or any hammer, because sometimes you don't have hammer on every Spectre miniature you have. Or here I'm using some Antalonica Wargaming miniature. Sometimes you just say that breaching charge, that hammer could be in the backpack, but again, this needs to be defined in the early stage of the game. If your breacher gets killed during the combat, don't worry, because there is some rule in Spectre Operation for picking up weapons or equipment on dead body. So if that happens, you can have another model that comes to the body of the dead breacher and try to pick up the hammer or the breaching charge. So now it's a couple of turns later, we managed to open that door silently, so we are still The enemy are still not alerted. That means we are still silently walking in that Afghan village. My objective for my Ghost Recon Operator is to secure that hostage over here. Here I could try to go all around and try to enter by one of the doors or that gate over here, but I can also try to breach through that mud wall with a breaching shaft. So this model, again, we can see on the back, is equipped with a breaching shard. So in the movement phase, that guy will just move to be able to fire when there will be a hole in that wall. So now it's the movement phase, that guy will move over here, he will place the breaching charge on that wall, and it will trigger the breaching charge. To see if that completely breached the wall, again, you need to do that breaching roll. So here we are trying to attempt it's a brick, it's a mud or brick or block wall, and I'm equipped with a breaching charge. So I need a 2+ to be able to break through that wall. So let's take my die. Same thing here, I'm just going to roll my die. I hit a 2, that means I successfully roll this. When you successfully roll on that breach table, in case of that mud wall, I created that just to fake a hole in the wall, just to see basically the different line of sight I could have with all my men, and so I can fire at the enemy on the opposite side. What you can also use is completely a different wall. Here one with that nice hole that will even be better just for realism and to have some cool looking scenery. When you are using a breaching charge, all the enemy located behind the breach point on a 6-inch radius will be stunned. So here we are still in the movement phase, I just breached through that wall, and if I take my ruler from the center of that wall, every enemy and actually every model, the hostage, will be stunned too. So here, 6 inches, basically, all those 3 enemy soldiers plus the hostage will be stunned until the next turn. And that's basically it for breaching. Thank you everyone for joining me, and I will see you all for the next one. Bye everyone.